Welcome to this .NET MAUI Chat Control tutorial. The Syncfusion.NET MAUI Chat Control offers a modern chat experience that displays conversations between two or more users in a fully customizable layout, featuring various types of content such as text, images, hyperlinks, and cards. In this video, I will show you how to add the .NET MAUI Chat Control to a .NET MAUI application. I will demonstrate how to add various message content types and customize message spacing. You will see how to use shapes, display attachment buttons, hide text editors and avatar names, and customize background colors. Before you begin, ensure you have installed the latest version of Visual Studio 2022 with the required .NET MAUI workload. You should also have one of the .NET SDKs installed on your machine. After installing the necessary tools, I launch Visual Studio and click Create a New Project from the dashboard. From the list of project templates, I select the .NET MAUI application and give the project name and location. I create the project with the .NET 8.0 framework. Now, the default application is ready to use. Before moving forward, let's take a quick detour to set up the application's environment. I select the Android emulators from this list to see the output in the Pixel 5 emulator. I'll run the application to show you the default output. The application compiles the default code in a few seconds. Now, the application's home page is displayed. Next, let me show you how to incorporate the .NET MAUI Chat Control into this application. I need to install the Syncfusion MAUI Chat NuGet package, so I open the NuGet package manager and switch to the Browse tab. I search for the Syncfusion MAUI Chat package, select it, and install it in my project. After the package is installed, I need to register the handler for the Syncfusion core to map the cross-platform control API to the native view API. I open the MAUI program CS file and add the Syncfusion MAUI core hosting namespace. Then, I register the Syncfusion core handler by adding the configure Syncfusion core method. Registering a trial license key is necessary to use Syncfusion MAUI controls. So, I open the appsaml cs file and add the register license method with the trial license key. To find out where to generate the key, please refer to the instructions link in the description below. Next, I navigate to the main page XAML to initialize the control. I remove the default code from the content page section and import the Syncfusion MAUI Chat namespace. Then, I initialize the .NET MAUI Chat control to display the collection of messages exchanged between users. I create a view model folder. Inside this folder, I create a class named GettingStartedViewModel and change it to public. Then I add the Syncfusion MAUI Chat namespace and define a field for the current user and create an observable collection property named messages of object type to store all messages in the group chat. I add a constrictor, initializing a new collection for the messages field, and assign a new author instance to the current user field with a name set to Nancy, an avatar set to an appropriate image name stored in the resource folder. Next, I create a method to generate messages. Within this method, I utilize the add method of the messages property, passing new instances of text message, and set appropriate values for the author and text properties. Similarly, I populate the collection with additional messages. Finally, I call this method in the constrictor. Once done, I navigate to the main page XAML file to bind data. I import the namespace of the view model and add the binding context to the content page. I access the data view model class here using the local XML namespace. Then I assign the messages field to the messages property and set the current user property to the current user to differentiate between the sender and receiver. Once the application is loaded, you can view the conversation in the group chat and send messages using the text editor. Now I will show you how to display a date picker as a message. For that, on the ViewModel class, I locate the generateMessage method. I add a new message of type datePickerMessage, then set the appropriate values for the author and text. In the last message, you can now see the date picker and select a date in it. In a similar fashion, you can add a time picker, calendar, hyperlink, image, or card message in the chat. If you want to learn more about this, refer to the documentation link provided in the description below. Next, I navigate to the main page XAML. To display the time break between the messages, I set the showtime break property to true. Notice the time break appears. To increase the gap between the messages, I set the message spacing property to 24. By default, it is set to 8. Now the spacing between the messages has increased. By default, the message shape is set to rounded rectangle. To customize the message shape, I set the message shape property to dual tier drop. In addition to these shapes, it also supports other shapes such as rectangle and teardrop. You can see that the message shape has been customized. Now I'll demonstrate how to display an attachment button. When the attachment button is pressed, a file will be sent in the conversation. To achieve this, I set the show attachment button property to true. And wire the attachment button clicked event to a new event handler method. I set the name of the chat control as sfchat to act as this control in the code behind page. I navigate to the event handler method. Here, I add a new image message instance to the chat control's messages property and set the appropriate value for the source and author properties. Once loaded, tapping the attachment button will send the image to the group conversation. You can also access the file from the local system by customizing the control. Next, I navigate to the main page XAML. To hide the text editor, I set the show message input view property to false. Observe that the text editor is disabled. You can see that the author's name and avatar show for only incoming messages. To show them for outgoing messages, I set both show outgoing message author name and show outgoing message avatar to true. You'll see that the author's name and avatar are displayed for outgoing messages now. Finally, to customize the background color, I set the background property to the color I want. Looking now, the background color is customized. In this video, you learn how to add a Syncfusion.NET MAUI chat control to a .NET MAUI application. I demonstrated how to add various message content types and customize message spacing, shapes, attachment buttons, text editors, avatar names, and background colors. To learn more about the chat controls features, check out the documentation link in the description below. I have also included a link to check if you qualify for our community license, which gives you a free license key for our entire .NET MAUI control suite. If you found this video helpful, don't forget to click the like button and subscribe to our channel to watch more videos like this. Thanks for watching.